Is it any better? Wow, a lot of people were didn't even see the first one. The first 5 minutes. It's better? So, good morning. Some of you missed the initial buster because we got rid of that to try to make it better. And maybe it's better. So, look, what I was saying is, yeah, I've been doing these every day. Too close? We all right? And sometimes they're better than others, and sometimes they don't do much. But they get me up, and they get me doing something. A lot of us are in compromised positions because of what we're going through. You know, the monster is gone, but the darkness remains on a lot of different levels. Economically, weather-wise, health, plague. People's employment. And when I started doing these, too close, use whatever options you have at your disposal to maintain your sanity without hurting yourself or others. It was primarily just to engage and get my brain going. So now it's part of a process. It's part of a ritual that I have. I get up, I do my yogas, I do the stretches, do the meditation. Make coffee, come down here, do this for an hour. Daily routine. Sometimes these are fun, sometimes they're okay. But the truth of it is, there's not 200,000 people watching these. It's like 800, 900 of you, and anywhere from like 10 to 30,000 come by during the day. I don't really pay attention to production or really what I'm doing. And the truth, as time goes on, you know, what I start to do things I never would do in front of people before. And I really believe it's helped me. It's always been my belief that, you know, during this time of quarantine and fucking darkness and inability to see or make plans for a future, that we're all going to end up sort of landing in ourselves eventually. Like, you'll know who you are. It's sort of like when I do an interview. You know, you can't hide for an hour. And if you're hiding an hour in, that's sort of what you do. You're that person. You hide. And that's all right. That's who you are. But I think we're all going to sort of land in who we are for whatever that's worth. And it's worth a lot. You know, truth will set you free, I guess. So the point is, you know, I don't sing in front of people. You know, I don't, hang out and, you know, love my cat in front of people. But because I started doing it, it's been able to open that part of me in the midst of all this grief. That's, you know, better. But, you know, I'm starting to sort of be reintroduced to who I am. In terms of the baseline, what's there from the old days, what's new, you know, what do I really give a shit about? Some of it not good, but the process of me engaging in all these weird things, playing guitar, and like, I know I'm not that great a guitar player, and I'm certainly not that great a singer, but I do it. And, you know, the vulnerability of it is what it is, but I just put it out there because it creates a muscle for me to be more fearless in fucking life, you know? Comedy is a business built on defensiveness. You know, you become funny to protect yourself, generally, or to hide. So, anyway, Cat Stevens. I woke up to this email from, it could be from a dude, could be from the troll, could be from somebody, I don't know, but it's Diane Disc. You really need to get over your fucking self. You're obsessed with your daily Instagram live. It's pathetic and sad. Your followers are just lonely sheep hanging on every stupid word that spews out your mouth. Subject line, read this. So this was important for Diane to write, like right when she got up. I mean, this came at 3:34 a.m. Now, I don't need to, I don't read all the emails, and you know, I kind of poke through them, right? I'm not here because, you know, it's a habit, and certainly I like entertaining you people. I'm an entertainer. First and foremost, I'm an entertainer. You know, but it just gets, it gets to a point where, like, even with trolls, it's like, what are you doing? What are you doing? So I wrote, eh, who cares? We're all just trying to get through it. Matters zero. We have a good time, burn an hour. The real question is, why the fuck would you write this angry, hurtful garbage? You don't have to watch. It's that easy. Who's sad? And did that make me feel good to write that? Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Fucking allergies out here, man. The wind has been crazy. But I can only assume that she got on here going, I wonder what this is. And, you know, maybe I said something shitty to her. Who the fuck knows? Yeah, man. I mean, times are shitty and they're weird. I'm fortunate to be living in Southern California right now because it's like a shit show out there. And I feel bad for people who are freezing. You know, it's much worse to be too cold than too hot. When are the sheep t-shirts coming out? Diane got a reply. That's another thing about me I don't understand. Like, I'll respond, you know, if somebody triggers my anger, that's the problem with trolls too, and they know it, is that, like, you know, I want to respond, but then they sort of win. But this was just one of those things, you know, it's clearly, and I've written emails like that, where you just, like, you get that fucking reaction, you feel that, and you're going to fucking, you know, give somebody a piece of your mind. For what, though? This, like, I don't even understand it. It's like, is it pathetic? Maybe it is. Maybe we're all fucking pathetic. We probably are, but that's the human condition, right? We're fucking pathetic. And anybody who puts a lot of effort into not being pathetic, they're desperate. And anybody who is, like, too cool to be pathetic, you know, they're working for a living and, you know, ambitious. And anybody who makes you feel less pathetic for a little while, they're professionals. Yeah, man, but I do know this, because when somebody says pathetic, I start to wonder, like, yeah, because I do get obsessed with shit. You know what I mean? I get obsessed with socks. I get obsessed with pants. I get obsessed with process. I hold on to things I don't need to hold on to. I get, you know, like, I get a lot of mail. Oh, thank you for, I can't thank everyone individually because I don't have it in front of me, but somebody sent me the Teenage Fan Club album. Thank you. I think Gemma painted me a nice painting that's at the office. Very nice. Thank you. Someone named Julie sent me some coffee. Thank you. Melody sent me some books and some records. Thank you. A lot of things coming, and I appreciate all of them. We can't do show and tell every day. But some of you, we could do show and tell. Look at that. This is the picture box. I pulled this out on Dean's show. This is the picture box. This is a lifetime's worth of pictures. That's a new game. Do you want to play the picture game? Which Teenage Fan Club? The one with the car on front. You want to play a picture game? Like a raffle? You want to do a picture raffle? Oh yeah, the mug. This is not the witch box. Okay. Oh my God. All right. There's so many. You don't even know what we're really dealing with here. Like, a lot of pictures. I pulled that Macintosh turntable out of the office. That's what I did yesterday. I got a new needle. And I got the old turn. What was I doing? This turntable is so much fucking better than the one I had. And it was just sitting over there in the office with a shitty needle on it because I was hung up on the cover. And then I immediately broke the cover when I got the thing home. This is something I do. I don't know if I won't recommend it, but it's something I do innately. If I have a new nice thing that I'm excited about, I'll fuck it up. So almost immediately. All right. How are we going to do this game? I'm just going to reach in and pull out a picture. Whoa. Fat Mark in his shiny suit. It's not a great one, but this is a picture of me. Look at that tum tum. That's my friend Paul's mother. That's a guy named Mark Atkins, and I'm not sure who this is. This was taken at the synagogue when I did a benefit for a Hebrew school teacher. Let's find that one. I like that suit. I wore that suit on my first Letterman. I guess I'm just gonna, I can't get lost in these, man. There you go. Backyard wedding day. That didn't last. This is one. Why am I having a hard time with this fucking tripod? Why can't it just be? What if I turn this around? Hold on. I'm trying to. No. Yeah, maybe that's it. This is even further back. This is my first girlfriend, my girlfriend in college, Sarah. I showed this on Dean's the other night. Look at that mark. Wow. Look at that mark. That's before all the hurt came. That's before I fucking lost my mind. That's when I was open. All right. We don't need to do all this. Do we? Naked with a guitar. What do you mean we're going to do a family picture right when I get out of rehab? Do we have to do a family picture right when I get out of rehab? With my drug hair? This is not the good day to do a family picture. I just got out of rehab. Play the Wild, the Innocent, the E Street Shuffle. I think we'll get in trouble for that. No? I feel some people were denied Buster time. Let's go do some pathetic Buster time. Buster! Buster! Hey! 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 What are you doing? Why are you back there? Come on. Come on, buddy. What are you doing? Buster. What's going on? Is it because you were up all night fucking high? Huh? Waking me up at 5 a.m? Remember that? Wow. Did you think you were going to die? That's what I used to do. I would wake up my wife at 5 a.m. because I thought my heart was going to explode. And tell her I was having an anxiety attack. Not so fucked up on the coke I didn't tell her about. Come on, buddy. Come on, Pally. Come on, Pally. What do you say, Pally? What do you say? What do you say? Huh? Yeah, the old panic attack excuse. I'm just freaking out. I don't know why. It's because I was out doing blow by myself. All right. I think I explained it all. You want to do some music? I am going to get a kitten. Kit has found a kitten, not through the shelter she works at, but through some people that know of the shelter. They've got a feral that's had a couple litters. So the cat that I'm going to get, I saw a picture of it. It looks like it's going to be a gray or brown tabby. And we'll see. Solitary blow is it's really the nicest kind of blow. It's the better blow, the solitary blow. Cocaine psychosis is brutal. The last G. Did we never do the last G? We can check it out. I can't tell you how much fucking better this fucking stereo sounds. I mean, you're not going to be able to tell from the phone. All right. Yeah, we can do the last G. It'll be Mingus. The cat's name will be Mingus if Mingus fits. I'll have to see. God damn, man. How is it that I can't fucking, operate a tripod? God damn it. What is fucking up? Fuck it, Cat Stevens. What the fuck is happening? Fucking drag, dude. I mean, it's like, how complicated could this be? What if I go that, you can't do that. Fuck, man. Shit. All right, hold on. I was trying to do it so. Ugh. Yeah? Yeah, maybe. Let's see. Better? No? Hold on. Yeah, it's intro. What is this? Vanguard connoisseur. I can't fucking... Like, I sat here all fucking night listening to records. Because I was like, holy shit. What the fuck was I doing? Thank you. Why is this sticking out here? When did that happen? I ain't writing no screenplay. Not me. That shit is behind me. Watermelon, man. Yeah, I ain't writing a fucking screenplay. I ain't doing nothing. There's a good chance that after this is over, I'm fucking out. If I can. It's hard to find the point in most things. I'm excited about the new Bruce Wagner novel. It's so funny, I tweeted a picture. Bruce Wagner... The story that I heard was that he went to publish this novel with a small press, and the small press got hung up on some of his language because one of the characters called herself fat and said that they couldn't publish it, that he had to reassess the language because it was triggering. What the fuck is wrong with people? Are we just going to kill art? Is the left just going to kill art? Is that what we're going to do? Are people that fucking soft? Really? Fat? 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 What the fuck? So he self-published it. He just put it up for free and is allowing people to publish it on their own. So I got a copy of Bruce Wagner's Marvel Universe Origin Stories novel. And he's really the best at writing about Hollywood, man. He's fucking cutting. Brutal satire. Brutal. Gemma, did you send me that painting? All right, what's next? What do we got? Come on, man. Let's be pathetic. What pathetic thing do we have to do next, my pathetic friends? Read you some. Go online and read it. BruceWagner, I think, .com. M6. One, two, three, four, five. Huh. Read you some novel. The fuck? Seriously? Okay. '50s in your bedroom at the moment. Huh. That's bad. Stay under that quilt, man. Is my hair triggering you, Baldy? Really, Baldy?
magnetic field. Did you listen to that Scott Fagan episode I did? Stephen Merritt, the guy who is the magnetic fields guy, was like the bastard son. I don't know if you say that. His mother had sex with this old weird Caribbean folk singer and didn't tell Stephen about it. And this guy turned out to be this Scott Fagan guy who made a record called Something Pacific Blues that was reissued a few years ago. And they never knew each other and they met each other. And there's a similar vibe to their song, their sound. You hear that? There's Caribbean in there, man. That story about Stephen Merritt's dad is wild. Scott Fagan. I don't think I have any psychic TV because it's a little tedious. Psychic TV is sort of a collectible and it's an exercise in sort of, you know, pre-techno weirdness, but it's not an easy listen. Hi, old man.
Hello.
I am old. It's crazy. 57. I was thinking about this morning. It's a great story. That whole fucking thing was... All right, what are we doing? Fuck, where was this? M, right? M6. That's plenty of time. What do you want? Brian Eno? Will that get us in trouble? Middle of P. Psychic TV is good late at night on drugs. Well, there you go. I think we just did the middle of P, but I'll try it again. Can't play any Floyd. I think that would definitely get us into trouble. Pixies, yeah, I don't know. I don't even care if we get in trouble. It doesn't matter. It's like 60, I don't know what it's like here, it's like 65 here. I like this one song on here, or I like the whole album, but the one that the lady sings, I like a lot. I think that the lady was... I think, didn't she, this woman, go out with... Elvis Costello? Where's the one? Yeah, it's the Pogues, but what's the one? What's the one that the woman sings? Fuck it, I don't remember. Makes me sad. Is it the second one? What's her name? Whoa, I nailed it. Is this it? Kate, yeah. Thank you.
When I first came to London, I was only 16, with a fiver in my pocket and my old dancing bag. I went down to the deli to check out the scene, but I soon ended up upon the old main drag. There are miles and the she-miles parading in style.
What is the name of that song?
Gotta find it. That's it.
Oh yeah, Old Man Drag, yeah. That's not her name, Christy McCall, is it? Isn't it like Kate? Kate O'Riordan. Maybe they were married. I love this song.
Well, my name is Joxter Ty McCannigan Moore, and a roving young fella I've been. So easy and free when you drink and with me, I'm a man you don't meet every day. I have acres of land.
True? Ophelia, Kate's the one he's singing about in Beyond Belief? Fucking Beyond Belief. How many times have you listened to that song? Fucking listen to that song fucking over and over again. I still listen to that song. Great.
Oh my God.
I was supposed to interview Tim Allen today, but he moved it to next week. So that's a load off. That is shocking that Shane McGowan is still alive, right? Can we have Irish Hour? Nah. I don't know if I have enough. Yeah, man, I fucking, Beyond Belief is like, what a great fucking song. What are we doing? How did I become interested in Ireland? I'm not sure. I think it was really the first time that I went to Ireland. I was just so taken with it. And I was fairly, it was the Kilkenny Comedy Festival. And I remember I was alone. I was not happy. It was not going well. But I was so taken with Kilkenny and the green and the sort of strange kind of persistence and spirit or whatever I projected onto the Irish people. Dude, Buster, what are you doing? And I went to AA meetings in a castle, like this weird, like it seemed like a castle. And I just got just taken with it. It just affected me deeply. V8, I don't know. All right. Well, I avoid this usually, but I'll do it. Me and Tim Allen, polarizing duo. I don't know, man. It's just a comic. Comics are usually comics. I usually avoid this because it's too fucking sad for me, but I will do it.
for, because just in the name of legitimacy, transparency. I don't know what Buster's doing over there. Get off the feed, Aaron.
Oh, Loretta, she's my barroom girl. Wears them sevens on her sleeve. Dances like a diamond shines. Tells me lies I love to believe. Her age is always 22. Her laughing eyes a hazel hue. Spends my money like waterfalls. Loves me like a water. Loretta, won't you say to me, darling, put your guitar on, have a little shot of booze, play a blue and wailing song. My guitar rings a melody, my guitar sings Loretta's fine, long and lazy, blonde and free, and I can have her any time.
That goes out to Texas. Don't worry about it. Was I just going to address something? I don't fucking remember. Oof. Yeah, I'm not going to talk to Tim Allen about politics. And, at some point we've got to, got to talk. We've avoided it long enough. He's got a real deal comedy story, man. That dude did jail time. I got to ask what's his name? Talent, Sam, if that's who we base that character on. That was nice pull. Thank you. It's not just a turntable. The turntable sounds better, but it's this fucking needle, man. I can't even begin to tell you, man. Oh, fuck. I gotta work out. And I gotta record for tomorrow. Tomorrow's Sam Neill. Sam Neill's gonna be on. That was great. It's so funny because, like, if I get somebody and I get them laughing, hey, what are you doing? Tell me what you're waiting for in there. What are you waiting for in there, Buster? Buster! Hey. 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 Buster. Hey. Hey. What? But if I get... I got Sam Neill laughing and then I just couldn't fucking stop. He was great. We had a great time. What kind of needle is it? It's a henna. What do you want to do now? How much time we got left? 8:15. 5 more minutes. Where do you buy needles? You buy them at the needle exchange. Get them for free. Make sure you clean your needles. What's up, bud? Huh? What's up? Are you anxious? What are you anxious about? Buster? Buster? What are you anxious about? Huh? You all right? What are we doing? What do we got? Please fix my smoke detector. Maybe you should maybe get on medication for your OCD. How would that be? Is that what that was? Is that what that is? You hear it? I was wondering what it was. I don't know which one it is. Maybe it needs a battery. I don't think I get the new kitten for a few weeks. I don't know, like it's still nursing. We're gonna let it keep nursing and then we'll get it. Oh yeah, I don't know, I gotta find which detector it is. It's chirping. My smoke detector is chirping. There goes someone running away, running. Ah, it's nice and chilly out here, not freezing. So sorry, everywhere else in the country. This is what we're dealing with. It's so funny, yesterday I talked about the hawk poking around in that nest up there, and of course somebody immediately wrote, that's a squirrel nest, and it is not. A lot of know-it-alls. It's a hawk nest because I saw them build it, and then I saw them have kids in it. I know, man. I know. My allergies were so fucked up yesterday, I was like leveled. I couldn't even watch another episode of that Adam Curtis because I just didn't want to fucking get sad. Which smoke detector? That's the weird thing about smoke detectors is you got to figure out which one it is, but there's only that one. Fuck, man. 818. What's up? Huh? Somebody sent this in a package. I think this was in Julie's package with the coffee. What kind of hawk? I think they're Cooper's hawks out here. All right, man. Maybe I'm winding down. Maybe we've gotten to the bottom of it. Where the fuck is that smoke detector thing coming from? Just replace all the batteries? I could do that. Arabic trolls. It's a beaver dam. Yes. What's amazing about tree beavers is that you never see them. Jodie Foster was great, thank you. Here's a weird picture. Look at that fat face. Fat young face. Shortly after drug time. Might have still been in it. That's sort of a weird look. Those glasses. Cooking Thanksgiving dinner. Tree beaver. I had something going on here. Not sure what that was. damn, my ex-wife was so pretty. So pretty and hates me so deeply. This is one of my favorite pictures. What was I thinking? Deep in the drugs, wearing a hat, dark glasses, smoking a cigarette, and my Circus Vargas shirt at Laughs in Albuquerque. Panama Mark is right. Oh my God, so many pictures. All right, you guys. There you go. That's me and my first wife and my father. College. Drugs. All right, you guys. Oh, 8:23. Barry, please stop. Barry, stop it. Barry, pumpkin. Gimper, come here. Gimper, get off of that. Mango, 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 please. Buster, Buster, please. Buster, Buster, Buster. All right. Sorry I didn't catch on fire today. I can't catch on fire every day. It's okay. Use whatever options you have at your disposal to maintain your sanity without hurting yourself or others. Buddha phase.